I don't know if you are tired now at the moment, because after this, these are two meetings, two speeches. No? I think that these two guys, they are very, Mr. Pablo, Ivan first, and Pablo, they are two of them, both of them are friends of mine. Yeah, I worked with Ivan the first for a long time in the past government. So we know very much very well, but it's the thing that he is able to do and explain. He is like a professor, and there's all the Spanish that he did is like very instructive for all the people, because he has to explain everything, every step. Yeah, he stands for the council of the government, of the administration. He has to explain very well, but it's the relations between one thing and another. No? Pablo, I know Pablo from my studies here, when I was studying in Madrid. I know they have more information because he was the first director of the RIA 2000, the association where he had taken part in the renovation of Bilbao. And after these two ideas about about Bilbao, or what is the transformation of Bilbao, I want to show you very briefly when it's not, Bilbao is not only done by this important or the biggest well known architect. The other architects like me and others, the people they're here, that we are involved in the place in Bilbao, you are a part of them as well. No? We took part because we stay here, we remain, before, now, and in the future, for I don't know for how long, but we always suggest all the responsibility of the people who are working here is stronger than the other architects like Foster and Sosaki and all of these ones. No? The things that we have to do here is they are more. We don't have this kind of freedom that we have, because we have to manage our work inside the rules that is managing the town planning and the constitution. So the freedom that this other entity has is not the freedom that we have. We are more control, and all the projects on the standard project we are going to show you is. You have to consider this area, no? Even every of this one, Rafael Noleano, Aradi Sasaki, Sisa, so all of these architects have to, they have close to them in a local architect one, because it's the obligation. They can't work by their own, they have to take it and decide the local architect, because the local regulation, the responsibility on the to manage other kind of things. There are two, in each project, there are two areas. Is the very well known, and the other not so well known, this local one. They have their own responsibility, and they took part in this conference, in this works, managing the real, making real the design of the everyday is happening in the construction. Okay, let's see. This is my practice, the name. And some of yours have been in my office this morning, so I want to introduce me only very briefly. Now, I finished my studies in 1979, and I started working in the Basque government as with Ivo was there, and I stayed there for 8 years after it opened in 1987. I opened my practice. After that, I was during 2 years in 1985, 1986. I was responsible in the Basque government for the social housing and the architecture area. I was the director of this area. So, and after that, I returned to my office. And it was considered there was when the boom below was starting really, and we started the collaboration and we're doing. Taking part in Delhi and lots of the parts of the Bilbao, in this problem of Bilbao. No? Yeah, you can see here, this is the difference that in red dots just appears which is the main interaction that's very of the public. But the price which are very good now, just the Google 9, just we heard about the Google 9, find the additional Escaluna, the conference center, the Arhitekture, the football stadium, this Salondiga, this the library of the Playa, and you can see in the yellow dots, this the where's the area when we took part in different kind of projects. No? And we designed two hotels. This is the Susaki project. We took part because as a collaborator with them. Yes, here's the hotel experience we do ourselves. The GADD, this the dominant, which is very close to here. Even appears Mariscal as the designer. This is only interior design, no, it's an architect. So it's the main thing, the design of the building is doing by myself, by my team. So, but he is as better known than me, so this is more, it's more trend to say that this made by Mariscal, let's say, but Inaki Aurrekoetxea. Obviously, but this is the thing that we have to pay, but. So, yeah, as you can see, we take part in several projects in this transformation in Bilbao, and in very important residential areas, and the renovation of the historical buildings and hotels. This is a project. So, in the last one, we are collaborating with the other project, and this one is Garayano residential buildings, which the master plan was done by Richard Royes. I want to see what is the different kind of the projects. The Melilla neighborhood is the area is in area we designed as the first or the biggest area for social housing. Was done by the private clients. It's 3,000 housing, and 65% of their housing was social one. Then there was from the study at the end was around was made in the last 8 years. Yes, 3,000. Yes, we took part in the initial design. It was an old mining area, so the design was not very free. Yes, because we had to consider what is the special, what is the ground, what is the system ground, where. So to analyze in which part of this ground was possible to build the buildings. No? And this is the design. There's two main areas. This is a great boulevard because he is a very, very great, very special area where it was not possible to build any, and this is a special, very, very slope. So we have to keep all the other residential space for in the possibility areas. Then you have to consider the difference between the two. The two points with more the difference in the height was more than 60 meters. Yeah. This is lower and this is the highest 60 meters difference between both. So it's like a little mountain. This was an historic building. It was one of the first concrete structure was built in Spain, and we have transformed into from the initial industrial building to the residential one. We have designed here some apartments, keeping the existing structure and flats. Well, there was only doing inside in renovation, keeping us, putting the different walls to divide the apartments and outside of the structure because the structure is important. So our goal was to be possible to see the value of the existing structure into the apartments. This is the image of the finishing building. This is the old one. This is the station we designed to connect the two buildings. We recovered the roof because it wasn't that one. Now here is the building name. Here is the hotel domain, GADB. This is the name. We are located just in front. It's very complicated. This is another. It was an existing another building there before. Industrial before it was transformed into a court, the local court for a time, for a while, and after that the promoters reached an agreement with the owner to transform this building into the hotel. And that moment the location of this hotel was very important because it was in front of the Guggenheim, and so to attract any people to come here, this delegation is impressive, no? Because you are going to face into the Guggenheim, which is not only a museum, it's a reference in the world of the architecture. So we have to give some references and very special intervention here. No? there are two sites, this in the existing city and the new place and the new area, as Yvonne and Pablo told us, because all of the city, as you can see here, is not fishing to the sea, to the river, they are fishing to the inside. So this transformation is very important, yeah? And this to be coming, and to recover the harbor areas to incorporate to the city, the city has to image or has to face to this area as well. This was the initial sketch, but this is because they are too wide and too long in this area. This is the sidewalk and this is the 16th street. It was the only street that you can enter to the hotel. So we decided, instead of to create a patio, to create a hall where a covered space where you can use between this transition, this side to this other, to have the lights inside the building, and be able to use this area for other purposes, like this, the people who is coming here. No? This is the system design, it was divided, this is the street, the enter, this is the patio, this is the hall, the atrium where is located, the tree, this is the place where is the reception, this is the bar facing to the Golden End, this is a space for the bar, when not only this bar, this for drinking some spirits, the spirits orient, and here is located the stairs, and here we put the lifts, and we cover this area with because from here came down the entrance to the garage, there was interference between the roof of this entrance with this area, and we decided to cover that, including the design of a fountain, like a fountain covering and giving another kind of image to this project. This is the last construction of that was the initial design, was the decision of the construction, how it is in this moment. And this has two kind of difference of the design. This is the more normal facade, because now it's between two historical buildings, so no flat, no qualification, more simple in a way not compete with the existing buildings. This is some images of the lobby on the entrance of the stair, and this is the area that with Mariska we decided to put into the facade, as instead of have a curtain wall, to put different kind of porting walls with different kind of slopes, yeah? in the way you try to have a reflection, not only of the existing Guggenheim, even for the existing surrounding area, which is the mountains and the trees that is involved, no? Because the situation in Bilbao is very specific, because the mountains limit the possibility of growing Bilbao through the sites, and the river gives to the, there's not another city, but between the river and the mountains, this got a specific quality. So it's important to reflect what is happening, not only in France, yes, and the other side as well. This is the layout of the apartments. You can see here there's different kind of shapes of the system of the rooms that is here facing to the Google 9. Inside rooms, it has immediately to receive the light through this lobby, and here the other rooms go face to the existing street. And as in this building of Bilbao, there's the different kind of companies of hotels decided to come here. So they are using the system specific area, and this site was the only one system in Bilbao who have a prominent system and the tree that facing really to the river and to the south. And this area was a place close to the, as this one, close to the Calatrava Museum, okay, the bridge, and close to the Sosaki, which the company, or the Esperia company, decided to build plots and to build another hotel. So here, this area of website, as you know, normally the architecture for the hotels, it could be a little bit boring, because this night is quite all the time the same. It's the same room, the same facade, the same extension. So normally, there's the image that you can and in the design you can introduce in the project. It's not could be can be a little bit boring. Or, and we decide in this facade they are covering an element which is important in the architecture in Bilbao is the mural. It's like an element that can help us to compose the building and introduce the color, because in Bilbao the existing color is not very, it's only, it's only the red of the bricks. This the debris of the environment, because this day is very sunny, but normally the weather here is very, it's very rainy, and the sky is cloudy, so it's not the color is could be important. And with these two elements, with the color and the using, instead of the continuing element with molecule, we decided to put like a unique element for each apartment in a way to using 6x6. These are 36 boxes with a different color, put in different positions to give to the hotel as a reference. That's the interface into the city. Otherwise, it could be only another one building. No, it means that for this kind of buildings to have a reference into the city is could be interesting. And I mean, the way to how to locate it, how to when you are looking in the hotel, this is my hotel because this is the one, this is different one. Here is the layout of the building and some details of the project. Is how the inside from the inside you can see the outside, no? How the color affects the inside. But after some minutes inside you, they are not the difference in the colors. The color is part of you. Is corner, and we took the decision not using introduce the color into the side facade, using the different kind of design of the building or the windows, and introducing some reference the color that connected the two sides, no? the main facade with the outer one. This is Sakatea that you have in the morning with Josep. It was an historical, it was a warehouse, a poor warehouse. It was a transformation. From here became the first one, the railway, as Yvonne explained. He was a part of the port. So, as you can see, this, what is the connection, the relation between the existing city, this is the 19th century city, with the surrounding area. This is the new areas. It's only in these areas, it's the outside of the center, this is where there is the more highest building. No? For this reason, and because the axe is the system, what is important on this street here, we start in the city center. Yes, in the main street around here, this is a very square, this is a round square. Around where there appears, there are like a different streets who appear from this side. To connect the city of the river with other side of the city. So this street was blocked because the difference between the levels, there are 13 meters difference between the city in the 19th century with the harbor. So you had the idea was to connect the street and more the way these two parts using the very stairs like using the reference of the. As the Spanish stair in Rome, because they are a space where the people use for the different kind of purposes. So the stair half here, this is 5 meters wide, so the 5 meters wide to 30 meters wide. So it's a space you can use not only for like a stair, you can use it like a different kind of, during the different period of the time there, the people are going to use like they can want. No? And then after that, put in the both sides of this stair, these two buildings, like an entrance, like a new entrance of the city, and to because this is the way for connect the one side, the side of the original side of the river, with the 19th century city, through the bridge, which initially was designed and built by Calatrava, with the extension of this bridge, we were designed by Arhitekture, and to connect with this, in this central point, and to make easier this connection, and to make possible to connect this area of the city. Yeah. There's different images and the cars reflected. And they, in this project, as to certain explain you, this morning they are using three kind of materials, the glass, the stone and the brick. And because using the different, with the scale of the buildings, they are composing all of the complex. Yeah? If the inside has the bridge that connects, is the town, the existing town road, and the road is behind, and with this bridge, they are doing the possibility, make the possibility to connect this to solve this hole. Hmm? And one of the main problems we have here, in considering what is the problem of the construction, as there was a system of five levels of car parks was built when we took part in this. We had to build or create a new foundation and in the first level. And for that, we had to use a 90 centimeters wide concrete pretense. Like a system here, you can see here, was they are using the how the content will reinforce these new foundations to be possible to the new structure that not always coincident between the old and new one. Here was we consider that because the difference between the levels, the structure will be wider when it is here, but we want to maintain the dimension of the buildings or the structure all of the construction. So you can see here that this is one of the goals that we reach using the different kind of solution, making with using the concrete and with the concrete slabs and with the columns of iron or steel. Here, this is in the process of construction. We have the collaboration not only with the Iraqi society as well with the German one. It was an expert in cutting work. You can see here with the different kind of colors and the different kind of companies of things that we were studying what was the profitable, what was accurate for the intention of everyone's, no? In a way, because it's not normal to using a curtain wall for duelists. No? This is an apartment and a curtain house that has interferences between what is the atmosphere that you're creating because the heat and because of the hot and the sun and in summertime and the cold in winter. So we have to consider which kind of the glass we are going to use, what is the transference of the hot between the inside and outside. And in the opposite way as well. Mm. Here is located, there's another inside all of this area that's formation that I want to explain to this is now in Nevada, and it was a former area of the harbor. It was possible because I know you understand very well what is the intention that Ivan has when he was explaining. All of this area was public area, and when you are not only the public, as well as and the private area, when we are intervening in this, in the town planning, we are creating the plus values or the new earning for the owner of these plots, of the owner. So, if you are the owner, if the owner is private, they are going to sell to some clients, so they are going to pay for that, they are going to build. But in this case, the owner is the public, is the administration. So they sold all of these plots for the private purposes. So they took a lot of money because this is a very interesting area for the new housing. It's very, very expensive. So they pay, or the client, the promoters here pay a lot of money for build these buildings. With the money that the public administration received for in the selling of these areas, they obtained the money enough to make the transformation of the public spaces. So this is not only the collaboration between the public and public, the different kind of administration, is between the intervention of the public or the private clients in this project that will be possible to do in this very short period of time. Because this transformation in Afghanistan, as you can see, since 1995, to now, which is less than 17 years. In 17 years, the transformation is in mission. it's not possible to understand. It's not understanding because if you not consider this the intervention of the private is very important as well. And this is the part with other client. It's the same client, the same client with we design and build this Sake project is the client that bought this plot and do this building. It's, you can see there's two absolutely different architectures, no? It's the languages. The reason for that is because in this area, all of these plots, they was imposed by the company below Area 2000 to have a mixed intervention in the architectures. They are local architecture one, but with you have to take part with another international or very well-known architects. When our client bought this plot, there was an obligation to choose between 17 architects, international one. Inside ones, one of those was Rob Creer, which studies this one. This is the style of Rob Creer and his friends. So the Bilbao Town Council, they want to have well-known architects involved in this project. And one of those was this Rob Creer, which architecture is not in trend in the moment, it's not. The artists that normally they are accurate in Europe because they are, the tendency is another one. But in this style, there's a lot of people, normally there are other architects here in Bilbao, in the Basque Country, they consider this kind of architecture anachronic. But they can there because they have their, in this it's one building, but this is designed like 18-1. Yes. They have 18 different facades that compose all the building. Like, there was considering that the existing city is done but side by side. It's only part of one. It's not. It was complicated to do this kind. We have 140 apartments. We have big apartments that there's not traditional works in history to do in one way, in one hand. So it was within time by time. Slowly, so this was the idea that Rob Creer introduced in this project. And the techniques and the composition of this is not is in terms of aesthetic, it's using the traditional the method and the rhythms and the measure of the elements of the traditional architecture in the old architecture or the architecture of the 14th or the 16th or the 15th times they was doing. So is the profiles, they are the profiles, the same profile that was done that you can find in any part of the historic buildings in 17th, 16th, the centuries. So isn't very professionally, taking very key care with what is the details, what is the parts that compose the building. As this, a new construction with the old design. But this design is built with the last techniques, because it's possible to do this because there are some elements that they provide with this, all the kind of profiles is possible to do using the glass of the piers that the German people drink. So this is a transformation or reusing of the glass of the piers, or the great beer bottles, that these people use or transform into a new material that you can give the profile that you want. As this is the material they use in all of the profiles that appears in these elements. And this and the other of the but the other thing is using the external, this exterior outside isolation. So the isolation in this building is not inside, it's outside. So gives to this building in terms of the really what is in this moment, this current tendency to preserve the no or the low cost into not using as low energy that you can use in the for heating or to maintain the climate of the inside for the housing. This is the system that they are using in this building. So this is the last modern, or the one of them, it's not the only one, but this is the last materials that you can use in the construction. And the finishing of this is with the traditional system of the past, and plus this using the stucco and the different kind of colors. So this is if you are not understanding that this kind of building is possible to do using the last technology in the construction, it's not you talk on the left now, this is anachronic. I think it is possible to sometimes. It's the people understand things in a different way. The artists, the professionals don't like it, the most of them. But the people of the camp of the city, this is the building that they like it, because it's they have the relations or the reference with the buildings that where they grow up. It's the system building. This is the I feel more comfortable. I accept this kind of designing better than the just in front. This is the design of Carlos Ferrater, which is absolutely the system tendency nowadays. This kind of other kind of architecture. So this is only like a little explanation for why this building is new, but this is a different one. And Robert Pierre introduced, as usual, in his work, different kinds of a lot of numbers of sculptures. There's sculptures in different sides to the building, because for him the architectural sculpture is his life. You can see all details. Here you can see the sculptures that he designed. And given importance not only to the center and to the outside facade, even for the inside patios. So it's this is designed and built like a external facade. This is not normal that you can find everywhere. Because that is part of the building, there's not even more importance in the design of the promoters. But in this case, because this man or this guy, we give this kind of importance, we design this facade like a Western external one. No? This is the facade they are giving that facing to the park. This is designing like in Gothic style. And you can see here, there's two faces in bronze here. And you can see here this difference between the different kind of buildings as was designed, as a part of that. We designed first the layout of the apartments, and after that, with the design of the apartments, it was given the different kind of faces. This is the inside detail. This is new, but it's done with the laser. It was cut with laser, given number for this one, and it's not using this kind of technique is possible to do. It's not very expensive. It's expensive not because it's marble, but it's less expensive than everything. Everyone can think. That's not this. It's introduced the sculpture inside of the hall or the entrance of the building. Here is the finishing of the interior of the one apartment. And this is all inside. I think that you are quite tired at the moment, but if everyone wants to know something or maybe any question, I have time. There's not a problem with my time. Yeah.
Thank
hotel room. It has a view on the
island that was lost in the foundation. And we were saying this shouldn't be destroyed. It just has to have a different use menu so we can have a touch with the history. And then we have also the park. So could you give me a number, some pros and cons of this whole process that you're going to do?
Yeah, I think I understand what you say. The city is a mixture of architectures, it's a mixture of styles, it's a mixture of the time. So I think it's every kind of style have to have their space in the construction of the city. I have to tell you that after the night, the construction of the Guggenheim, which is that the effort, the Guggenheim in the local architecture is much bigger than normally you can think, or we can think. Not only because the image, which kind of building it is. It's because transform the image or the possibility or gift for the people, for the town people. You know, it's possible for the kind of architecture, open the design in the mind of the people who they are involved in this in the process of transformation of the world. Because it's not only the public. The public administration wants well-known architects and different kind of teachers because they want to attract other kind of, they want to show what is this transformation. The well-known architects, they're important because they are giving another kind of image of them and project the image of Bilbao in the books and the reviews so and magazines. So. And the local architects transform this idea and give they believe more in his possibilities and to introduce more on a different kind of style in the architecture. No? This we can, in the images of Ivan Shaw, and there appears two buildings, is the church and the library, which is close to the county. County library is very close in the city center. It's designed by the IMB firm. One of those architects was we met in the study. We started studying together in 1970s. So this is one of the firms, very most important firms in Bilbao, and they are even another kind of image. They are working very well with the new architecture and the new style. I think that, but the traditional people, that normally is not the new ones, I think the young people prefer new architecture. But the people who are able to buy this kind of buildings, they are more aged, have more, they have another kind of education. And in his mind, his reference is more in the traditional architecture than the modern one. And sometimes the new, I think that the architects, so this kind of architects that appear here, don't take in consideration some, because of this, I started saying that these architects came and go. They only stay only for the work, and after that they're going out. But we remain here, we stay here. And when I'm working by the town, it's not a big one. Bilbao is it's a very small city. Yeah? So you are looking every there's a lot of people that know you. And I tell you, I like it, don't like it, but you do it. So we have to take a lot of care. It's very easy for the politicians to say we have to come here, to Alex Sosaki, to the Frank Gehry, the Vichy Field, so there's a Jan Nobel, the project of Jan Nobel that show you Ivan. We are, our firm was involved in that project as well. The local architect was, we have to discuss to do possible the design of Chernobyl. But the design of Chernobyl is very, no, it's amazing in the image. But the reality was, the apartment was impossible to build. Not to build, it's possible to sell. Because there was an apartment that's 150 meters and one room, which is impossible to sell now here. So sometimes the image or the design is good for to show, but not very good to do. So the in the middle is the, if it could be the, and all the things, it is good. But the local people or the local artists are very important in this, because you know really what's happened, you know what's really the mentality of the people, and you have to balance between the outside architectures and the local ones, the local people, the citizens.
Well, I had a question, but it was actually very similar to the Marta's. But anyway, since your office is working with one of those famous architects that were invited to design the city, could you, well, let's say, imagine the scenario that instead of those famous architects, those projects were given to the local architects?
What would the bow look like? Would it be different? No, the effect is not going to be the same.
What?
No, the effect or the result is not going to be the same. I think it's very important this they call it the intervention of this well-known architects. Okay, introduce quality, introduce change, but connecting with this one, these another ones, they are you, your country. It's possible that there was an international competition, they have invited every cheaper field or MVRDB or this or someone to do some, okay. But the local artists have to learn how they work, how they are working, and they are able to open the mind of the local politicians. To be able to the local architect can express his capabilities, his expression of his work, all kind of buildings, no? Why not? No? It's not only doing by this way because this is the rules. I think it's important, but not only that architect, the local architect as well, this both of them. So, for example, no, it's not possible to imagine that. Hmm? It's, I was another way. No, it's different to imagine. Because it's, the most difficult is to imagine the changing in the mind of the political responsibles. Because this is the importance of this architect is they are able to make possible to change the mind of the authorities. Is and the effort on this kind. Because not in everywhere you can build in a Google name. But there's you can introduce into the city other architects to can change. And there is in the town planning this, I think this is one of the parts where these films can give more opportunities because they are moving in other kind of minds. The possibility is no rules, no controls. So they have this place in the last one that Father had it designed for the sovereign. I can't imagine the local ones or the best local architect one. There is one doing this kind of design. We are more block our mind with another kind of situations. Either have more, less capabilities to discuss with the proposals with the local authorities. They respect more to the foreigner than the local one. So the state below would be another different. There was some parts of the city would be similar, but other ones not. Through Tange to connect with us, but this is a thing that our goal was to receive you as well as we can and give you all the opportunity to know our city as I would like to know your city as well. These are two meetings. Two speeches. Huh? I think that these two guys, they are very, Mr. Pablo, Ivo first, and Pablo, yeah, two of them, both of them are friends of mine. Yeah, I worked with Ivo the first for a long time in the past government. So we know very much very well what is the thing that he is able to do and explain. He is like a professor like this. All the Spanish that he did is like very instructive for all the people because he had to explain everything, every step. Yeah, this time for the council of the government of the administration, he has to explain very well what is the relations between one thing and another. No? Pablo, I know Pablo from my studies here, when I was studying in Madrid. I know they have more information because he was the first director of the RIA 2000, the association where he had to take part in the renovation of the bar. And after these two ideas about the bar, or what is the transformation of the bar, I want to show you very briefly when it's not, because it's not only done by this important or the biggest well-known architects. There are other architects like me and others, the people have, they're here, that we are involved in the place in the bar, you are a part of them as well. No? We took part because we stay here, we remain before, now, and in the future, for I don't know for how long, but we always suggest all the responsibility of the people who are working here is stronger than the other artists like Foster and Sosaki and all of these ones. No? The things that we have to do here is they are more. We don't have this kind of freedom that we have because we have to manage our work inside the rules that is managing the town planning and the constitution. So the freedom that this other entity has is not the freedom that we have. We are more control. Mm-hmm. And all the projects on the standard project we are going to show you is you have to consider this area. No? Even every of this one, Rafael Moniano, Aradi Sasaki, Sisa, so all of these entities have to they have close to them in a local language as well, because it's the obligation. They can't work by their own. They have to take it and decide the local language because the local regulation, the responsibility, and the manage other kind of things. There are two, in each project, there are two areas. Is the very well known, and the other not so well known, this local one. They have their own responsibility and they took part in this building, in this works, managing the real, making real the design of the everyday is happening in the construction. Mm-hmm. Okay, that's this is my practice, the name. There are some of yours have been in my office this morning, so I want to introduce me only very briefly. Now, I finished my studies in 1979. I started working in the Basque government as with Ivo was there, and I stayed there for 8 years after it opened in 1978. 87. I opened my practice. After that, I was during 2 years in 1985 and 1996. I was responsible in the Basque government for the social housing and the architecture area. He was the director of this area. So, and after that, I returned to my office. And it was considered there was when the boom below was starting really. And we started to collaborate and we're doing, taking part in very, really, in lots of the parts of the below, in this global number. Yeah, you can see here, this is the difference that in red dots disappears, which is the main interaction that's very of the public But the price we sell is a very good now. Just the Google 9, just we talked about we heard about the Google 9, find the additional Escalduna, the conference center, the Arhitekture football stadium, this Alondiga, this the library of Vizcaya, and you can see in the yellow dots this the where's the area when we took part in different kind of projects. No? Then we designed two hotels. This is the Suzuki project we took part because as a collaborator with them. Here's the hotel Speria is we do ourselves. The GADV, this the Dominion, which is very close to here. Even appears Mariscal as the designer. This is only interior design, no, it's an architect. So it's the main thing, the design of the building is doing by myself, by my team. So, but he is as better known than me, so this is more, it's more trend to say that this made by Mariscal than say by Inaki Aurrekoetxea. Obviously, but this is the thing that we have to pay, but. So, yeah, as you can see, we take part in several projects in this transformation in Bilbao, and in very important residential areas, and the renovation of the historical buildings and hotels. This is a project. So in the last one, we are collaborating with the other project, and this one, this Garayano residential buildings, which the master plan was done by Richard Royes. I want to see what is the different kind of the projects. The Meridian neighborhood is the area is in area we designed is the first or the biggest area for social housing. Was done by the private clients. It's 3,000 housing, and the 65% of the housing was a social one. Then there was from the study at the end was around was made in the last 8 years. Yes, 3,000. This was we took part in the initial design. It was an old mining area, so the design was not very free. Yes, because we had to consider what is the special, where is the ground, what is the system ground, where. So to analyze in which part of this ground was possible to build the buildings. No? And this is the design. There's two main areas. This is a great overlap because he is a very, very big, very special area where it was not possible to build any, and this is especially very, very slope, so we have to keep all the other residential space for in the possibility areas there. Then you have to consider the difference between the two, the two points with more, the difference in the height was more than 40, more than 60 meters. Yeah. This is lower and this is the highest, 60 meters difference between both. So it's like a little mountain. This was an historic building. It was one of the first concrete structure was built in Spain, and we had to transform into from the initial industrial building to the residential one. We designed here some apartments, keeping the existing structure and flats. Well, there was only doing inside in the renovation, keeping us, putting the different walls to divide the apartments and outside of the structure because the structure is important. So our goal was to be possible to see the value of the existing structure into the apartments. This is the image of the finishing building. This is the old one is the station we designed to connect the two buildings. We recovered the roof because it was another one. Now here is the Google 9, here is the Hotel Dominion, GADV, this is the name. We are located just in front, it's very complicated. This was an existing other building there before, industrial before, it was transformed into a court, the local court for a while, and after that the promoters reached an agreement with the owner to transform this building into the hotel. And that moment, the location of this hotel is very, was very important because it was in front of the Guggenheim. So they were for to attract any people to come here. This delegation is impressive, no? Because you are going to face into the Guggenheim, which is not only a museum, it's a reference in the world of the architecture. So we have to give some references and a very special intervention here. No? There are two sites, this in the existing city and the new place and the new area, as Yvonne and Paolo told us, because all of the city, as you can see here, is not facing to the sea, to the river, they are facing to the inside. So this transformation is very important, yeah? And this to the coming and to recover the harbor areas to incorporate to the city, the city has to image or have to face to this area as well. This was the initial sketch, but this is because there's too wide and too long this area. This is the side of the night, this is the 16th street. It was the only street that you can enter to the hotel. So we decided, instead of to create a patio, to create a hall where a cover space where you can use between this transition, this side to this other, to have the lights inside the building and be able to use this area for other purposes, like this, the people who is coming here. No? This is the system design, it was divided, this is the street, the enter, this is the patio, this is the hall, the atrium where it's located, the tree, this is the place where the reception, this is the bar facing to the Guggenheim, this is a space for the bar, where you can not only this bar, this for drinking some spiritualism, and here is located the stairs, and here we put the lifts, and we cover this area with because from here came down the entrance to the garage, there was interference between the roof of this entrance with this area, and we decided to cover that, including the design of a fountain, like a fountain covering and giving another kind of image to this project. This is the last construction of that was the initial design, was the decision of the construction, how it's in this moment. And this has two kind of difference of the design. This is the more normal facade, because now it's between two historical buildings, so no flat, no qualification, more simple in a way not to compete with the existing buildings. This is some images of the lobby on the entrance of the stair, and this is the area that with Mariska we decided to put into the facade, instead of having a curtain wall, to put different kind of porting walls with different kind of slopes, yeah, in the way you try to have a reflection, not only of the existing Guggenheim, even for the existing surrounding area, which is the mountains and the trees that is this involved, no? Because the situation in Bilbao is very specific, because the mountains limit the possibility of growing. Bilbao through the sites, and the river gives to the, there's not another city, but between the river and the mountains, this got a specific quality. So it's important to reflect what is happening, not only in France, yes, and the other sides as well. This is the layout of the apartments. You can see here there's different kind of shapes of the system of the rooms that is facing to the Guggenheim. Inside the rooms, it has immediately to receive the light through this lobby, and here the other rooms go face to the existing street. And in this pool of Bilbao, there's the different kind of companies of hotels decided to come here. So they are using the system in a specific area. And this is this site was the only one system in Bilbao who have a prominent system and the tree that facing really to the river and to the south. And this area was a place close to the, as this one, close to the Calatrava Museum, okay, the bridge, and close to the Sosaki, which the company where the Spanish company decided to buy plots and to build another hotel. So here, this area of website, as you know, normally the architecture for the hotels, it could be a little bit boring because this night is quite all the time the same. It's the same room, the same facade, the same extension. So normally, it's the image that you can and in the design you can introduce in the project. It's not could be can be a little bit boring. Or, and we decide in this facade they are recovering an element which is important in the architecture in Bilbao is the mural. It's like an element that can help us to compose the building and introduce the color, because in Bilbao the existing color is not very, it's only the red of the bricks. This degree of the environment, because this day is very sunny, but normally the weather here is very rainy, and the sky is cloudy, so it's not the color is could be important. And with these two elements, with the color and the using instead of the continuing element with the mural, we decided to put like a unique element for each apartment in the way to using 6x6. It's 36 boxes with a different color, put in different positions to give to the hotel as a reference, as the reflection to the city. Otherwise, it could be only another one building. No, it means that for this kind of buildings to have a reference into the city could be interesting. And I mean, the way to how to locate it, when you are looking in the hotel, this is my hotel because this is the one, this is the different one. Here is the layout of the building and some details of the project. Is how the inside, from the inside you can see the outside, no? How the color affects the inside. But after some minutes inside you, they are not the difference in the colors. The color is part of you. This corner. And we took the decision not using, introduce the color into the side facade, using the different kind of design of the building or the windows, and introducing some reference the color that connected the two sides, no? the main facade with the outside one. This is Sakyatea that you have in the morning with Josep. It was an historical, it was a warehouse, a poor warehouse. It was a transformation. From here became the first one, the railway, as Yvonne explained. He was a part of the port. So, as you can see, this what is the connection, the relation between the existing city, this is the 19th century city, with the surrounding area. This is the new areas. It's only in these areas, it's the outside of the center, this is where there is the more highest building. No? For this reason, and because the axe is the system, what is important on this street here, we start in the city center. Yes, in the main street around here, this is a very square, this is a round square. Around where there appears, there are like a different streets who appear from this side. They connect the city of the river with other side of the city. So this street was blocked because the difference between the levels, there are 13 meters difference between the city in the 19th century with the harbor. So you had the idea was to connect straight and by the more the way these two parts using the very stairs like using the reference of the Spanish stair in Rome, because they are a space where the people use for the different kind of purposes. So this the stair half here, this is 5 meters wide, so the 5 meters wide to 30 meters wide, so it's a space you can use not only for like a stair, you can use it like a different kind of during the different period of the time there the people are going to use like they can want, no? And then after that put in the both sides of this stair these two buildings like an entrance, like a new entrance of the city, and because this is the way for connect the one side, the side of the earth, another side of the river, with the 19th century city, through the bridge, which initially was designed and built by Calatrava, with the extension of this bridge, we were designed by the Arhitekture Saki, and to connect with this central point, and to make easier to this connection, and to make possible to connect this area with the city. There's different images and they're just reflected. And they, in this project, as explained you, this morning they are using the three kind of materials, the glass, the stone and the brick. And because using the different, with the scale of the buildings, they are composing all of the complex. If the inside has the bridge that connects is the town, the existing town road, and the road is behind, and with this bridge, who make they are doing the possibility, make the possibility to connect this to solve this hole. And one of the main problems we have here, in considering what is the problem of the construction, as there was existing five car parks, so five levels of car parks was built when we took part in this. We had to build or create a new foundation, and then in the first level, and for that we had to use a 90 centimeters wide concrete like a system here. You can see here what they are using, the whole content to reinforce these new foundations to be possible to the new structure that not be always coincident between the old and new one. Here was we consider that because the difference between the levels, the structure will be wider when it is here, but we want to maintain the dimension of the buildings or the structure all of the construction. So you can see here that this is one of the goals that we reached using the different kind of solution, using the concrete and with the concrete slabs and with the columns of iron or steel. Here, this is in the process of construction. We have the collaboration not only with the Iraqi society as well with the German one. It was an expert in cutting work. You can see here with the different kind of colors and the different kind of components of things that we were studying what was the profitable, what was accurate for the intention of everyone's, no? In a way, because it's not normal to use a curtain wall for duelists. No? This is an apartment, and a curtain house that has interferences between what is the atmosphere that you're creating, because the heat and because of the hot and the sun and in summertime and the cold in winter. So we have to consider which kind of the glass we are going to use, what is the transfers of the hot between the inside and outside, and in the opposite way as well. Here is located, there's another inside all of this area that's formation that I want to explain to this is now in the area, and it was a former area of the harbor. It was possible because I know you understand very well what is the intention that Ivan has when he was explaining. All of this area was public area. And when you are not only the public as well as and the private area, when we are intervening in this, in the town planning, we are creating the plus values or the new earning for the owner of these plots, of the owner. So if you are the owner, if the owner is private, they are going to sell to some clients, so they are going to pay for that, they are going to build. But in this case, the owner is the public, is the administration. So they sold all of these plots for the private purposes. So they took a lot of money, because this is a very interesting area for the new housing, it's very, very expensive. So they pay, or the client, the promoter here pay a lot of money for build these buildings. With the money that the public administration received in the selling of these areas, they obtained the money enough to make the transformation of the public spaces. So this is not only the collaboration between the public and public, the different kind of administration, it's between the intervention of the public or the private clients in this project that would be possible to do in this very short period of time, because this transformation in Afghanistan, as you can see, since 1995 to now, which is in this less than 17 years. In 17 years, the transformation is amazing. It's not possible to understand. It's not understanding with this. The intervention of the private is very important as well. And this is the part with other client. It's the same client. The same client with we design and build this Saki project is the client that bought this plot and do this building. This, you can see there's two absolutely different architectures. No, it's the languages. The reason for that is because in this area, all of these plots, they were imposed by the company Bilbao Ría 2000 to have a mixed intervention in the architectures. They are local architecture on one, but they have to take part with another international or very well-known architects. When our client bought this plot, there was an obligation to choose between 17 architects, international one. Inside ones, one of those was Rob Creer, which style is this one. This is the style of Rob Creer and his friends. So the Bilbao Town Council, they want to have well-known architects involved in this project. And one of those was this Rob Creer, which architecture is not in this trend in the moment, it's not. The artists that normally they are accurate in Europe because they have the tendency is another one. But in this style, there's a lot of people, normally there are other architects here in Bilbao, in the Basque Country, they are considered this kind of architecture anachronic. But they can there because they have this is one building, but this is designed like 18-1. Yes. They have 18 different facades that compose all the building. Like there was considering that the existing city is done but side by side. It's only part of one. It's not. It was complicated to do this kind. We have 140 apartments. We have big apartments that there's not traditional works in history to do in one way, in one hand. So it was within time by time. Slowly, so this was the idea that Rob Creer introduced in this project. And the changes and the composition of this is not in terms of aesthetic. It's using the traditional the method and the rhythms and the measure of the elements of the traditional architecture in the old architecture or the 14th or the 16th or the 15th times they was doing. So is the profiles, they are the profiles, the same profile that was done that you can find in any parts of the historic buildings in 17th, 16th, the centuries. So isn't very professionally, taking very key care with what is the details, what is the parts that compose the building. As this, a new construction with the old design. But this design is built with the last techniques, because it's possible to do this because there are some elements that they provide with this, all the kind of profiles is possible to do using the glass of the beers that the German people drink. So this is a transformation or reusing of the glass of the beers, or the great beer bottles, that these people use or transform into a new material that you can give the profile that you want. As this is the material they use in all of the profiles that appears in these elements. And this and the other of the but the other thing is using the external, this exterior outside isolation. So the isolation in this building is not inside, it's outside. So gives to this building in terms of the really what is in this moment this current tendency to preserve the low energy that you can use in the for heating or to maintain the climate of the inside for the housing. This is the system that they are using in this building. So this is the last modern or the one of them. It's not the only one, but this is the last materials that you can use in the construction that, and the finishing of this system with the traditional system of the past and plus using the stucco and the different kind of colors. So this is if you are not understanding that this kind of building is possible to do using the last technology in the construction, it's not you talk on the like, no, this is an acronym. I think it's possible to sometimes. It's the people understand things in a different way. The artists, the professionals don't like it, the most of them. But the people of the country, of the city, this the building that they like it because it's they have the relations or the reference with the buildings that where they grow up. It's the system building. This is I feel more comfortable. I accept this kind of designing better than the just in front. This is the design of Carlos Ferrater, which is absolutely the existing tendency nowadays, this kind of other kind of architecture. So this is more, it's only like a little explanation for why this building is new, but this is a different one. And Robert Pierre introduced, as usual, in his work, different kinds of a lot of numbers of sculptures. Yes. Sculptures and different sides to the building, because for him the architectural sculpture is his life. You can see all details. Yes, here you can see the sculptures that he designed. Is the given importance not only to the tenants for outside facade, even for the inside patios. So this is designed and built like a external facade. This is not normal that you can find everywhere. Because this part of the building does not give them more importance in the design of the promoters. But in this case, because this man or this guy, we give this kind of importance, we design this facade like a Western external one. No? This is the facade they are giving. To that facing to the park. This is designing like in Gothic style. And you can see here, there's two faces in bronze here. And you can see here, this difference between the different kind of buildings as was designed, as a part of that. We designed first the layout of the apartments, and after that, with the design of the apartments, it was given the different kind of faces. This is the inside detail. This is new, but it's done with the laser. It was cut the laser, given number for this one, and it's not using this kind of thing is possible to do. It's not very expensive. It's expensive, not because it's marble, but it's less expensive than everyone can think. That's not this. It's introduced the sculpture inside of the hall or the entrance of the building. Here is the finishing of the interior of the one apartment. And this is all the inside. So, I think that you are quite tired at the moment, but is everyone wants to know something or maybe any question? I have time, there's not a problem with my time.
Thank you.
connected urban growth and the public and the style of the architecture, but it's actually now a new picture of the sun. And this morning, we were staying in our hotel room. It has a view on the island that was lost in the presentation. And we were saying this shouldn't be destroyed. It just has to have a different use maybe, so we can have a touch with the history, and then we have also the park. So picturing in numbers some pros and cons of this whole process that you're going to do.
Yeah, I think I understand what you say. The city is a mixture of architectures, it's a mixture of styles, it's a mixture of the time. So I think it's every kind of style have to have here their space in the construction of the city. I have to tell you that after Guggenheim, the construction of Guggenheim, which is that the effort, the Guggenheim in the local architecture is much bigger than normally you can think, what we can think. Not only because the image, which kind of building it is. It's because transform the image or the possibility of gift for the people, for the town people. You know, it's possible for the kind of architecture, open the design in the mind of the people who they are involved in the process of transformation of the world, because it's not only the public. The public administration wants well-known architects and different kind of architecture because they want to attract other kind of, or they want to show what is this transformation. The well-known architects says they're important because they are giving another kind of image of them and project the image of Bilbao in the books and the reviews, so and magazines. So the local architects transform this idea and give they believe more in his possibilities and to introduce more on a different kind of style in the architecture. No? This we can, in the images of Ivan Shaw, and there appears two buildings, is the church and the library, which is close to the county library, is very close in the city center, is designed by the IMB firm. One of those architects was we met in the study. We started studying together in the 1970s. So this is one of the films, very most important films in Bilbao, and they are given another kind of image. They are working very well with the new architecture, the new style. I think that, but the traditional people, that normally is not the new ones, I think the young people prefer new architecture. But the people who are able to buy this kind of buildings, yeah, people they are more aged, have more, they have another kind of education. And in his mind, his reference is more in the traditional architecture than the modern one. And sometimes the new, I think that the architects, so these kind of architects that appear here, don't take in consideration some, because of this, I started saying that these architects came and go. They only stay only for the work, and after that they go and out. But we remain here, we stay here. And when I'm working by the town, it's not a big one. It's because it's a very small city. Yeah? So you are looking every there's a lot of people that know you. And I tell you, I like it, don't like it, but then you do it. So we have to take a lot of care. It's very easy for the politicians to say, we have to come here, to start Alex Osaki, the Frank Gehry, the Vichy Field. So this Jan Nobel, this the project of Jan Nobel that show you Ivan. We are, our film was involved in that project as well. The local architect was, we have to discuss to do possible the design of Chernobyl. But the design of Chernobyl is very, no, it's amazing in the image, but the reality was, the apartment was impossible to build. Not to build, it's possible to sell.
because there was an apartment that's 150 meters and one room, which is impossible to sell now here. So this, so sometimes the image or the design is, so the, is good for the for to show, but not very good to do. So the in the middle is the, if it could be the, and all the things it is good. But the local people, the local actors are very important in this, because you know really what's happened, you know what's really the mentality of the people, and you have to balance between the outside architectures and the local ones, the local people, the citizens.
Famous architects that were invited to design the city. Could you, well, let's say, imagine the scenario that instead of those famous architects, those projects were given to the local architects. What the Bilbao would look like? Would it be different?
No, the effect is not going to be the same.
What?
No, the effect or the result is not going to be the same. I think it's very important, this they call it the intervention of this well-known architects, to introduce quality, introduce change. But connecting with this one, these other ones, they are you, in your country. It's possible that there was an international competition, they have invited David Chipperfield or MBRDB or this or someone to do some, okay. But the local artists have to learn how they work, how they are working, and they are able to open the mind of the local politicians to be able to, the local artists can express his capabilities, his expression of his work, all kind of buildings, no? Why not? No? It's not only doing by this way because this is the rules. I think it's important, but not only that's architects, the local architects as well, this, both of them. So, for example, no, it's not possible to imagine that. Yeah, we say I was another way. No, but it's different to imagine, because it's the most difficult is to imagine the changing in the mind of the political responsibles, because this is the importance of this architect is they are able to make possible to change the mind of the authorities. Is and the effect on this kind, because the, not in everywhere you can build in a good name, but this you can introduce into the city other architects to can change, and this in the town planning is I think this is one of the parts where these films can give more opportunities, because they are moving in other kind of minds. The possibility is no rules, no controls. So they have this place in the last one that Father had it designed for the Forthright. I can't imagine the local ones or the best local architect one. There is one doing this kind of design. We are more block our mind with another kind of situations. It had more, less capabilities to discuss with the proposals with the local authorities. They respect more to the foreigner than the local one. So this state below would be another different. There was some parts of the city would be similar, but other ones not.
Thank you.
Yeah. Okay, so I thank you to you for giving us this opportunity, because it was only possible because through Tange to connect with us, but this, I think that our goal was to receive you as well as we can and give you one of the opportunity to know our city, as I would not know your city as well. But,